single most important impact that Alvis has had on the community is turning lives around. In our 50-year history, we have turned hundreds of thousands of lives around. Most of the folks were turned in the wrong direction, out of their families, not in their communities, committing crimes. And with Alvis, they received the resources to be able to turn their lives around.
What inspires me about Alvis is I have an opportunity to be up close and personal with a lot of the individuals that are going through the program, because at Reeb Avenue Center, we have programming for a lot of the transitional clients. And I think what inspires me is really seeing people from the beginning of the week, going through the program to the end of the week, have a completely different posture about themselves, a different sense of confidence. They say hello, they have conversations. You can see joy. And, you know, you can talk about programming, but when you see it literally transform people right in front of you, that's inspirational. Donato's has been in business for 54 years, and we've been working with Alvis for a really long time. And some of our very most dedicated, passionate, and loyal associates have been people that have had backgrounds and or overcome barriers, and they are with us still today doing an awesome job.
In the 35 years that I worked at Alvis House, I made changes in men and women's lives. I done things that I never thought I would do, from education to housing to making changes in their life. I gave them a plan to be successful. I gave them a master plan to help turn their lives around.
You can't punish addiction, number one, out of a person. Addiction is a disease. Over 80% of the population that comes through Alvis's doors has a substance abuse issue. Over 40% of those have a mental health issue. You cannot punish that. You have to treat that. And that's why I'm so proud that Alvis provides the programs to help them to be able to get their lives back together.
I think the leadership team and the staff at Alvis have a heart that is one of servant leadership. And I think their growth specifically is a reflection of the people that are working in the organization, because they're building trust with a community and people know they care about them beyond a number.
That's why we made Alvis one of our 5 nonprofits to watch. They are creative in an area of work that could be stifling because of its challenges. And their growth is astounding, and their service to others outstanding.
I think everyone should support Alvis. And my message would be because it makes a difference in the lives of others. It provides transitional services, and it sends a strong message that maybe I got into a little trouble, maybe I made a mistake, but that's just the beginning. It really doesn't matter where you start, it's where you end up. And Alvis brings that great ending to most of the stories. It takes a person through whatever process is best for them, uniting them with their family, preparing them for the world of work, helping them with their addiction, making them look back and saying, now I can move forward because of Alvis.
I think our community without Alvis would have less hope. And without Alvis, I think we would have a community of people that would be in search of something and trying to find their way, but without really the support system to help them get to that next level.
What more can we ask of ourselves and others than to summon the strength, the grit, the courage to be healers and workers and providers of opportunity, doers of social justice? Strength in times of weakness, that's what Alvis stands for, and that's what Alvis stands up for. They are some of the best.
What I would like to see happen in the future for our community and for Alvis is to provide more addiction and treatment programs. Every 33 seconds, someone dies of an opiate overdose, and we cannot allow that to continue. So an increase in treatment programs is imperative. I think it's important to concentrate on the people that are over 50 years old that really need services but are incapacitated or unhealthy that need to return to our communities. We're going to have to meet that need because they are going to be released, and ALVIS should be stepping up to the plate to take care of that population.
ALVIS was founded in 1967, so I used to be in the arts and entertainment world. I can't help but think of songs that might have been popular then and their applicability to this occasion. So two stand out. One is All You Need Is Love, and the other is Ain't No Mountain High Enough. So I think that pretty much sums it all up. They are all about love for those who need it most. And for Denise and her team, there ain't no mountain high enough to keep them from doing amazing things in new ways to help others in ever-expanding ways.
And as leaders, we need to stand with ALVIS and tell the story. Fight to make sure that they have everything that they need, whether it's in funding, whether it's in volunteers, because when you have a program like ALVIS, when you have a program that celebrates 50 years of incredible service and a leader and board of trustees that's all behind making a difference in the individuals, that's why I support ALVIS.
The most important thing to me is that it's rekindled my family back as one. We are now whole and we're able to sit as a family and during this setting and enjoy one another with nothing, no worries, no stress, and enjoy every holiday and every situation that comes bi-weekly or weekly at times with one another and just literally process it completely through. There's no barriers, no blockers, and nothing better is to give back the time that has been taken from my bad behaviors. To me, this program's gave my family back. What I'm looking forward to most of my new life outside of ALVIS is definitely the free spirit that I've learned to be. I am ready to live, I'm ready to travel, I'm ready to take the journey as it comes. I'm just ready to live, finally. At this point in life, I'm free.